Hey guys, welcome back to the Dark Table. Before we get started, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Now today, we'll be doing simultaneous equations with one linear and one nonlinear. So based on this example here, the linear equation would be equation one, because the highest power of the variables is 1. And equation 2 would be the nonlinear because the highest power is not 1. It is 2, etc. So the first thing you'd want to do is look at your equations, and I'd advise you to always use the linear equation to make either x or y the subject, as it will be easier to work with. So because we already have y as the subject here in equation 1, we're just going to substitute it in equation 2 and solve. So we have x squared plus 2x minus 3 all squared equal to 2. Now what is 2x minus 3 all squared? That's saying 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3. So that's 4x squared minus 6x minus 6x plus 9. So that's 4x squared minus 12x plus 9. So here we have x squared plus 4x squared minus 12x plus 9. And I'm going to carry this 2 over the equal sign. So it becomes minus 2 is equal to 0. So now we have 5x squared minus 12x plus 7 is equal to 0. Now we have a quadratic, and we can solve that using the AC method. So 5 times 7 gives us 35, and two factors that would give us minus 12 would be minus 7 and minus 5. So we have 5x squared minus 5x minus 7x plus 7 is equal to 0. So we factor out 5x, so we have x minus 1 minus 7, x minus 1, equal to 0. So now we have 5x minus 7 is equal to 0, and we have x minus 1 is equal to 0. So that means x here is equal to 7 over 5, and x here is equal to 1. So now using equation 1, where we had y equal 2x minus 3, we're substituting x here for 7 over 5. So that means we have 2 times 7 over 5 minus 3. So that's 14 over 5 minus 3. So now we need to find the LCM here, which is 5. 5 into 5, 1. 1 times 14, that's 14. And this will be over 1. 1 into 5, that's 5. 5 times 3, that's 15. So here, x would be equal to minus 1 over 5. Using the same equation, y equal 2x minus 3. 2 times 1 minus 3. So y is equal to minus 1 here. And that would be the answer. So when x is equal to 7 over 5, y is equal to negative 1 over 5. And when x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. So again, let's say we have this question here. X squared plus y squared is equal to 29, and y minus x is equal to 3. Now, based on this, you can realize that equation 1 here is our nonlinear, and equation 2 is our linear. Now, you realize that we have y minus x is equal to 3, so we can either choose x or y to be the subject. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to let y be equal to 3 plus x, and I'm going to call this equation 3. So now I'm going to substitute 3 plus x anywhere I see y in equation 1. So I have x squared plus 3 plus x all squared is equal to 29. Now what is 3 plus x all squared? That's 3 plus x times 3 plus x. So that's 9 plus 3x plus 3x plus x squared. So that's 9 plus 6x plus x squared. So now I have x squared plus 6x plus 9. I'm going to carry over the 29, it becomes minus 29 is equal to 0. So now I have 2x squared plus 6x minus 20 is equal to 0. I can now divide throughout by 2 to make this easier, because all the coefficients here, well, the coefficient for x squared, the coefficient for x, and the constant are all divisible by 2. So I'm going to have x squared plus 3x minus 10 is equal to 0. Now I can use my AC method, where 1 times minus 10, that gives me minus 10. So I have to think what two factors of minus 10 would give me positive 3. And that would be positive 5 and minus 2. So now we have x squared plus 5x minus 2x minus 10 is equal to 0. So we have x plus 5 minus 2, x plus 5, and that's equal to 0. So we have x minus 2 times x plus 5 is equal to 0. So x minus 2 is equal to 0, and x plus 5 is equal to 0. So now we have x is equal to positive 2, and x is equal to minus 5. So using the equation y is equal to 3 plus x, we have y is equal to 3 plus 2. That means y is equal to 5 here. Using the same equation, y equals 3 plus x, we substitute x for minus 5, so we have 3 plus minus 5, and that gives us minus 2. And that would be the answer. So when x is equal to 2, y is equal to 5, and when x is equal to minus 5, y is equal to minus 2. And so that's basically all there is to simultaneous equations with one nonlinear and one linear equation. Thank you guys for staying tuned, and I'll see you guys next time on the DarkTube.